Less than 2 months from now, we're going to be seeing iOS 12 Beta 1. Let's hope it's going to be a good one. In the meantime, I wanted to show Apple, or you guys, the best collection of concepts in one video. And these are coming from many different concept creators, and I just wanted to bring them all together with their permission in this one video, show you what iOS 12 could look like, and hopefully inspire one or two of Apple's engineers, although that's wishful thinking. They plan these features years in advance, and if we even see a fraction of these, I'd be happy. And to begin with, this is Avdan's concept. This is a look at iOS 12 in a very colorful perspective, and he imagines that 3D Touch will gain new functionality inside of the camera application, the health data application will be reimagined, and of course, the legendary dark mode, which wasn't released in iOS 11 with the iPhone 10. He imagines iOS 12 will finally bring it. Again, wishful thinking. I really hope it happens, but you know, Apple does not like to give us what we want usually. Hey, I was surprised this weekend though with the product red iPhone. In any case, dark mode, he imagines you can customize the toggles on the lock screen, which would be cool, especially on the iPhone 10. And you'll notice most of these concepts are focused on the iPhone 10, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but that doesn't mean that other devices won't be getting features as well. He imagines a colorful background in the settings, so a splash of color everywhere in iOS. And notice the color in the background of the music application, something I would really like to see in the stock music player, so it reflects off of the album art. But overall, a very creative concept, something a little bit different, very colorful. I do like this one. So hopefully Apple introduces something like this, and you'll be able to find the link to this concept down below in the description, as well as every other one I'll be showing you in this video, to check it out, of course, more in detail. So thank you, Avdan, for that one. Very wonderful. Moving on to a Behance concept. I actually showed you this in earlier videos, but it was removed for some reason. I thought it was a fantastic concept, so not sure why that happened. In any case, this concept imagines a reimagined lock screen where the information is displayed differently, a sort of shadow mode where your prompts and everything are a little bit darker, the dots concept where on the lock screen you'll be able to get notification dots depending on which notification you have, the smaller call notification so it doesn't take your entire screen hostage when you get a call, a guest mode where you'll only have selective apps you can open, the ability to lock certain apps, a reimagined Safari experience that makes it easier on the iPhone 10, and a must for me, the ability to change the settings in the camera without having to leave the app and go to settings. So this next one is provided by iUpdate OS. I actually saw this a few days ago, really liked it, and he gave me permission to share it with you. So this is a very wonderful take on what iOS 12 could look like. It has a lot of the same things from the other concepts, but shown in a different way. Lock screen gets reimagined with new dynamic wallpapers. The dots concept is there in its own way as well. And this one is really nice. Complications from the Apple Watch on the iPhone really make sense. There's also group notifications, which, oh my goodness, Apple is lacking in notifications so bad in comparison to Android. So the lock screen gets completely reimagined. Group FaceTime is wishful thinking. That will not happen because of patent disputes and stuff like that. Siri doesn't have to take your screen hostage. I mean, she could just appear there on the top. And I really, really think Apple should do something like this, either on the bottom or on the top. Siri would be getting smarter as well, allowing you to do new things like changing the volume to a certain percentage. Reminders is getting a complete revamp and a dark mode as well, which looks quite nice. I like this one. Apple hasn't touched this application in too long. The dark mode here, his take on it, looks really good. I like the contrast between the lighter gray and the pitch black. This would, of course, save you some battery life as well. Music app gets a slight revamp, so it looks a little bit cleaner. I think Apple really needs to focus on the music application as well. So a very wonderful concept. Do check this one out and check out iUpdate OS's channel as well. Great stuff. So I'll leave a link for that down below in the description. And this was a collaborative effort between several people, so it wasn't just him, but I want to say thank you to all of them. Just wanted to describe the points more in depth here because I thought they were a very good idea. Having complications from the Apple Watch on the lock screen as well as those notification lights would make iOS 12 a completely different experience for me. The volume HUD, I think, is a must at this point. It's been way too long that it's been there already. And they made a very good point that Apple needs to add more wallpapers. There's just not enough stock wallpapers. Every time Apple adds some, they remove some. Having some new emojis would be cool as well as a bar on the bottom that would keep the most frequently used ones in check. Also, I really like this redesign multitasking plus the control center together. And hopefully the behavior of the control center changes as well, where you can activate it from the bottom right of the display. That would make the usability so much better on an iPhone 10. Also some new animojis in there as well, like we received in iOS 11.3. Definitely count on Apple adding stuff to this. And moving on to a bubbly iOS 12 concept by Ascending News. This has a much cleaner and fresher look on iOS 12, very minimalistic and simple. There are group notifications, looks like something off of an Apple Watch. No labels on the home screen, very minimalistic, as well as the locked applications prompt you can see is very bubbly. The guest mode looks pretty decent, shades out the applications that aren't necessary. The prompts definitely look like an evolution from the iOS 11 style, and taking advantage of the organic LED display, you can save some battery life with a super saver mode and have an always on display showing certain information. So great concept from Ascending News. And this next concept by Lataya takes a look at the Apple Music application and experience. And I definitely like the focus on that because I think that needs an overhaul. And this one has a lot of throwbacks to the old days. There are a lot of quality of life changes detailed in this concept. I really like this one, ability to change the volume very quickly using 3D touch. Again, taking further advantage of that feature, something Apple should be doing more. You can also heart songs directly from the lock screen or like them directly on the now playing page as well. And this feature is super cool because it used to belong on iOS, but Apple removed it and now it's back. And he calls it landscape mode. It's also known as cover flow with Apple, where you can just swipe through all of the album art in landscape mode. It's super cool. This whole concept just looks natural, like something Apple would actually do in iOS 12, and I hope they do. This next one is where your album art reflects on the background, so that will change colors and pulse according to your music, and it's something like you'd see in a jailbreak tweak. I would love to have it in a native music application. And integrated properly, dark mode looks fantastic within the music application. On the bottom, your controls are highlighted against the black background. On the very top, the album art is in a darker color mode. It just looks very great. So this is the music application I would like to see in iOS 12. Apple, please do something with the colors. Very fantastic one. I like to see something more in-depth focused on just one application. And from the same concept artist, his take on the battery percentage problem on the iPhone X. This way, with this icon setup, you can actually have both the battery icon and the percentage on the iPhone X. I think it's a great solution. And this next concept by Nick Arthur tackles the notification problem that iOS has right now. You'll notice that many of the concepts I'm showing you in this video actually show a solution very similar to this, where you group your notifications. This one is just done very well. It's using the animations from the Apple Watch and the pop, snap. It just looks very native and good on the iPhone X. You know, I thought Apple would take more inspiration from the Apple Watch when building this thing, so I'd like to see some sort of animation change to the iPhone X, very similar to the Apple Watch, as well as the bubbly look the Apple Watch currently has. I certainly think that most people can agree that notifications are horrendous right now on iOS 12, and that's a great solution to that problem. So this next one tackles the widget issue. This way, with the live apps, Apple can implement widgets onto the home screen and still have it look native. I really like that one. Okay, so this next one isn't strictly an iOS 12 concept, but it could be a branch of an iOS 12 update. It's called Aerial, and after watching this concept, I think this certainly makes sense. So most of the time, we don't like where Apple leaves off older devices. They're slow, overpacked with features, just unoptimized for their screen sizes, and I think that Apple could make this new version, an Aerial version, like a light version of iOS 12, for older iPhones. What it would basically do is it would declutter the older phones, and by old I mean like the iPhone SE, iPhone 5S, maybe an iPhone 5 update, and this is not gonna happen, but I wish it would. So it would remove a lot of the features they don't need, maybe make it a little bit faster, optimize it, have a lighter load on the actual phone so it doesn't take up as much storage. But basically it would be a reimagined iOS for smaller screens, and that's exactly what this developer or concept creator had in mind with Aerial. And it's a fantastic idea. And while it seems completely out of the question, like why would Apple update their old phones for better performance when they could rather sell you a new one? But it does kind of make sense because a lot of people stuck with older phones have security holes or just stuck with a very unpleasant experience, and Apple could certainly help with a very light version of iOS 12 for those phones and just have it 1 year cycle, don't update every year, but make it easier to have an older, smaller phone in 2018. And this next one is kind of funny because this artist pushed this concept out before even knowing what the iPhone X would be like. So that wasn't even announced at the time. And this was his take on what the experience could be like using an iPhone 10 with an organic LED display before even knowing what it would be like. So the first thing that I took from his concept that I really like, and not everything, I mean, of course, Apple won't have the buttons on the bottom, but the always on display certainly makes sense. Obviously, no Touch ID sensor there on the front. The ability to lock apps with Face ID, not Touch ID. Having that in-app camera control for settings, and this take I actually really like. And if Apple were to put the control center on the bottom of the phone, the top would have this little quick menu drop down. And of course, a universal dark mode and recent apps when swiping over using 3D touch from the right of the display. So guys, there it is, a collection of everybody's iOS 12 concepts, and you guys can find the links down below in the description. Just want to say thank you for everybody for sharing this on this channel. Do check those out, and Apple, please take a couple pointers from this video.